उल्टा किया,
how gender sensitization can prevent.
their innocence. And this is how for 20 years it was done. But after POPSO, and they also work very seriously about this. They work on the next slide. So they work on this act. And now Bombay Municipal Corporation has introduced awareness about POPSO, that any form of child sexual abuse is an offense, and parent teachers association, principals association, you know, children are also told in the class that they can report about it to this thing. And children's version will be believed. Earlier, they really played a Freudian understanding. What did Freud say? Women and children always hallucinate. Because that is a famous sentence quoted to delegitimize experiences of women. Women's experiences can't be legitimate. Children's experiences can't be legitimate. Now, any type of child, even a child doesn't say anything from the body language, from the sadness on his face or her face, or not ready to, the child is not ready to go to school, but the moment she sees the conductor or driver, her facial expression changes, voice facial expression changes, they start thinking that there is something wrong in this setup. And now we see more and more cases are reported, at least in three cities, we see Delhi, Mumbai, and Bangalore. Now Bombay has gone one step ahead when they are training women to become bus drivers for school, and they are also contractors have been asked to train with, and conductor has to be woman in every school bus. These are the kind of GRs that Bombay Municipal Corporation has said. Now, what are the curriculum procedures and material for gender to deal with gender biases and inequality? That means that educational resources are not only textbooks. We also need a lot of other things like audiovisual presentations, posters, stories, the three-dimensional days, all of them have to be very important. Now, we have affirmative action which are taken by NCERT, by UGC, by Government of India, Ministry of Women and Child Development, state governments, municipal corporations, and even within Sarvashiksha Abhiyan, 30% of the funding has to be targeted to be. You just can't say that this year we have not been able to finish fund, we will divert it to some other funds, that can't be done. That's to be carried forward. So that can come. And another thing that was education for all, that we have a gender class religion. When we talk about gender, we are not only talking about man or women, we are talking about judge, or a doctor, or a lawyer. This kind of tools for creating the research center for human studies. We have jigsaws, we have pins, and snake and ladder games. And if you, in the education field, are more familiar with this kind of gender sensitive tools that we have in the dance, street plays, exhibition posters, they are also very important. Another thing is to study visits of places like I took my students to Railway Museum, and they see that in that, when they saw in what way in the last 150 years different people have contributed for development of Indian ladies, and now they reached a state where the Indian drivers are women because of their great and public experience. Another thing is interfacing role models, women achievers, women pilots, women scientists, but every time one of these goes up, is even to such women achiever guys in the university. You can see all the students being out and about the people. They start dreaming about such future. Kalpana Chawla's father, Kalpana Chawla as a child grew up in rural Haryana, where there are so many restrictions on women. Who responsible for that. Ministry of Science and Technology has come up with a new scheme called Disha, which is a major affirmative action for girls. And they have also come up with a beautiful book called Lila and His Daughters. And it was written, the author of that book was given on his Pulitzer Prize in 2 years now. For education, the main key components in when it comes to education, right? One is accessibility. Do we have we made our education accessible to all? Or still, there are so many sections of society who are excluded. Another thing is affordability, whether we have money. Because if what extent state has appropriate training institutions, how many institutions are private money? Where college is it? Schools, international schools, where you have to pay $20,000, or even rupees, maybe in the city of Mumbai. Or another thing is acceptability. That if they are poor, like slow learners, or dyslexic children, or if we be able to use or transgender, or in certain courses in the women, if they enter this institution, will they be accessible to them? Will they be acceptable? Initially, we saw in engineering college, there was tremendous resistance to women in this. The same happened in the Army, Navy, and Air Force, when women were, they were acceptable as doctors and clerks and cashiers. Not as a pilot or not as an officer. So the hurdles that come to women, mainly the child marriage is a major hurdle that India has faced. Right? Just 10 years back, 45% of Indian women, Indian girls were married before their 18th birthday. Now it's in annual exchange. In the last 10 years, there is a strong campaign against child marriage, which is taking place throughout the country. That is in Maharashtra, it is 22%. But still, 1/4 of girls in Maharashtra are still married before they do their business. And this is a major, a child marriage, which is a major hurdle to the very first marriage education. And you can see the pyramid at the primary stage, at the bottom of the education hierarchy, there are women studying very few marriage education. Role of teachers in gender sensitization is extremely crucial. Because teachers, they are rich between family and child. They are the child. The good teacher can make the subject, or they can make child totally averse to the subject. The teacher is not acceptable to the students. The teacher can prevent warlike situation within the class. Teacher can give new dreams to the students. And wherever we have seen successful students, they all attribute their success to their teachers. It's very important. And educated girl of today is an empowered woman of tomorrow. Educated her and she will spread light of knowledge that is the now. Because the teacher should have, and also empowering a girl child is a responsibility of all. And to all of us have been very important. And teachers have been played very important role in gender sensitization. In the class where children are given educational gender stereotypes and discriminatory beliefs. Need for gender sensitization in the modern context would be one of the subjects of today's seminar, where we talk about the equity, because equity is very important. Treating unequal people equally is also injustice. Okay? Because people with a totally poor child from rural area, the child from
So
equity is a